Let's look at a scenario where you assign roles and permissions for a team to manage planning data for the enterprise. The team consists of the following people: Barry, the team manager and application creator; Carol, who needs read-only access to planning data; Alex, who manages core planning dimensions such as accounts and products; and Casey, who manages mappings from a source general ledger application to the planning application. I am logged in as a service administrator. From the home page, I'll open Access Control and select the Assign Application Roles tab. Let's assign application roles to Barry, our team manager. I'll assign the application creator role to Barry, who needs to create and register applications. With this role, after Barry registers an application, he is assigned the owner permission for the application. Barry also needs the view creator role, so he can create views with viewpoints for users to view and manage data. With this role, Barry is assigned the owner permission for any view he creates. Note that users with the auditor application role can view changes made to data across all applications. However, they cannot make any changes to data. Now I am signed in as Barry, who has already registered the acquired general ledger and corporate planning applications. Let's assign permissions to the team members. Carol simply needs to view data for the corporate planning application. I'll open the inspector for the corporate planning application and assign Carol the participant permission with read access. Alex manages data and hierarchies for the account and product dimensions in the corporate planning application. With data manager permission at the dimension level, he can manage all of the data objects related to those dimensions. Select the Dimensions tab to assign dimension level permissions. I'll assign the data manager permission to Alex for both the account dimension and the product dimension. Casey manages account mappings from the acquired general ledger application to the corporate planning application. With the participant permission with write access for both the acquired general ledger account node type and the corporate planning account mapping hierarchy, he can add nodes to the list of acquired GL accounts and map them to the corporate planning account mapping hierarchy. Let's start with the node type permission. Inspect the account node type for the acquired GL application. Add Casey as a user and click Read to change the participant permission to Write Access. For users with this permission, you can configure data access for all actions or specified actions. The allowed actions vary depending on the data chain object. For node types, you can specify Add or Delete. I'll select Add, which will allow Casey to add nodes in a request, but not delete them. You can also configure which properties are displayed or hidden, and which properties a user can edit. I'll allow Casey to edit the description property, and I'll hide the enabled property. Now let's assign the hierarchy set permission. Open the hierarchy set inspector for account mapping, and assign the participant permission with write access to Casey. Note that the allowed actions for hierarchy sets are different from the allowed actions for node types. I'll select All. When Carol signs in, she can browse all of the views that have viewpoints for the dimensions in the corporate planning application. If the view contains viewpoints for dimensions in other applications, she will not see them. Because she has participant permission with read-only access, Carol cannot create requests. When Alex signs in, he can open views with viewpoints for the account and product dimension in the corporate planning application. As a data manager for these dimensions, he can create requests in these views. When Casey signs in, he can open views with viewpoints that contain a list of the acquired GL account nodes or the corporate planning account mapping hierarchy. Because he has participant permission with write access, he can also create requests in these views. Based on the permissions we set earlier for the account node type, notice that the description property is editable and the enabled property is hidden. Notice also that Casey can add a node, but he cannot delete a node. If you want more information on how to set up an approval workflow for requests, you can find links to our tutorials on configuring approval policies and incorporating subscriptions into approval workflows in the video description. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.